The following is a 5 for 2 production.
What the hell was that?
And now, virtually live from somewhere in America, it's the show you love. It's What the Hell Was That?
Well, howdy, folks, and welcome back to another fantastic episode of What the Hell Was That? Podcast number 2. I think the first one went very well. Got a lot of positive comments on the old internet there. Lots of likes on the YouTube channel. That's great. Did have a couple people say that maybe the show might have been a little too political. Well, folks, there are yammering yahoos all over right-wing radio who get 3 hours a day to spew their ignorance, hatred, lies, and propaganda. So, you know, fuck you. This is only a half-hour show. What do you want? Cute puppies and cat videos? Fine. Here you go. Here's your cute puppy for you. Yes, how about that? All you Trump-loving, gun-toting, flag-waving, abortion-hating good old Americans out there. How can you look at this cute little face and complain about that? So, folks, we'll be back with more. What the hell was that? Tonight's episode of What the Hell Was That? Brought to you by Trump Water. Trump Water, now with extra lead. Welcome back to What the Hell Was That? A lot has happened in Trump's bizarro world since last we met, so let's get right to it. Last week, Donald Trump complained his treatment by the press was worse than Lincoln, calling their questions biased, disgraceful, horrendous. Perhaps he doesn't realize that part of his job is to answer tough questions. It's not fake news just because they call you out on your bullshit, Donnie. And in another act of vanity and stupidity, Trump announced he was going to disband the coronavirus task force. Then, 2 days later, he reversed his decision because he had no idea how popular the task force is. Maybe somebody should tell him how popular birth control and Obamacare are, too. In a similarly idiotic move, Trump demoted Rick Bright, former director of the Biomedical Advanced Research and Development Authority, in other words, a virus expert, all because he dared question Trump's insistence that hydroxychloroquine could be used as a cure-all for this virus, even though there was no or little evidence whatsoever to back that claim up. When asked, Trump said he'd never heard of him. The guy said he was pushed out of a job. Maybe he was, maybe he wasn't. I don't know who he is. I did not hear good things about him. And to me, he sounds like a disgruntled employee that's trying to help the Democrats win an election. Bright responded by saying, I'm not disgruntled. I'm frustrated at a lack of leadership. You're not alone, pal. And just days later, the Office of Special Counsel, a watchdog group, recommended Bright be temporarily reinstated because they found reasonable grounds to believe that the administration was retaliating against Bright. No. You don't think Donald Trump would fire somebody just because they disagreed with him, do you? Well, now the Trump administration is refusing to follow CDC guidelines at all, essentially giving governors carte blanche as to how to reopen their states. Gee, just last week, Trump claimed to have total authority over these states. Well, he was wrong, again. But wait, it gets worse. The Senate is now back in session. Not you'd know it since they're not answering their phones. But Rand Paul is refusing to wear a mask on the floor of the Senate because he claims to have immunity. I've already had the virus, Paul said, so I can't get it again, nor can I transmit. I'm about the only safe person in Washington. And this dipshit is a doctor? Do me a favor, Rand. Next time you see that son of a Mitch McConnell, go up and give him a big French kiss on the mouth, would you? Let's test that theory of yours. Speaking of idiots who refuse to follow guidelines, Shelley Luther, a Texas hair salon owner, was fined and briefly jailed for refusing to close her shop, claiming she had to feed my kids. Really? She has 2 kids from a previous marriage. A slut. But you may not know this, folks. She also has 6 horses, 3 mini horses, 2 donkeys, 11 goats, 3 ducks, 6 dogs, a wallaby,
a ringtail lemur, and a Bengal cat. Clearly, this overprivileged cunt is not hurting for money. She's just another Trump-loving attention whore trying to get her 15 minutes of fame, which she has achieved. Every right-wing radio douchebag is holding her up to be some kind of American hero. In fact, her GoFundMe account has reached $1 million. Maybe she can use that money to pay her employees instead of making them risk their lives for minimum wage. Not to worry, though. Texas Governor Greg Abbott and Attorney General Ken Paxton, two raging Republicans, overruled the Dallas judge's decision, calling it a shameful abuse of judicial discretion. Once released from jail, Shelley then took to the airwaves like a fundamentalist preacher trying to raise bail money. She wasn't struggling to feed her kids, and if she was, there was plenty of options available. She could have gotten a business loan. She could have gotten unemployment. She could have gone to a food bank. She could have gone to a local church. Hell, she could have sold her animals. She could have eaten her animals. I hear horse meat's a delicacy. You know, hey, Shelley, ever heard of food stamps? Trump and the Republicans in the Senate are now trying to cut food stamps at a time when millions of American children are going hungry every day. Literally, one out of five children born to an unwed mother are now not getting the proper nourishment they need. How Christian of them. Folks, even God thinks Trump is an asshole. On that note, we're going to take a quick break, but we'll be right back after this word from our sponsor.
Attention conservatives, do you love America? Do you love God? Do you love God and America? Then you need Donald Trump's bottled water. Yes, indeed, straight from the lead-based pipes of Flint, Michigan, and bottled by Chinese slave labor in the Wuhan Peninsula, this is the best non-purified water your tax dollars could buy. And it's EPA approved because Donald Trump fired the head of the EPA. They don't give a shit about water quality anymore. Dial 1-800-MERICA for your own bottle of Trump water. Only $19.95. But wait, there's more. Act now and you get a second bottle of Trump water absolutely free. Just add additional shipping and handling, $29.95. If you don't drink Trump water, you're probably a socialist.
What the hell was that? Jesus, Kevin, I'm all for corporate sponsorship, but I'm not selling my soul to Satan. By the way, this water tastes like shit. And speaking of Satan, on Tuesday, Trump issued an executive order using the Defense Production Act to force meat processing plants to remain open, without enforcing any safety guidelines whatsoever, and despite hundreds of cases of workers who are already infected with the coronavirus. All I gotta say is I'm not eating anything from Tyson or Smithfield for a long time. And you know, to be honest, folks, considering America is one of the fattest countries in the world, maybe it's time we all eat a few more fruits and veggies, huh? Now we know that both Trump and Pence have a White House staffer who has tested positive for the coronavirus. Yet, Trump still refused to wear a mask, probably because he knows it'll mess up his hairpiece. Mike Pence won't even wear a mask in the hospital. I guess he figures God will protect him and to hell with everybody else. These are our leaders? And yet these dummies are still going full speed ahead with reopening the country. You know, it's because of their ignorance that Dr. Fauci, Dr. Redfield, the head of the CDC, and Dr. Hahn, the head of the FDA, are now self-quarantining due to their possible exposure by standing next to these two morons. Well, I guess that's one way to get them out of the daily press briefings. Even more disturbing, Fauci, Redfield, and Hahn testified in front of the Senate yesterday by video conference. Yet, Trump blocked them from testifying in front of the House because, and I quote, "The House is a setup. They're a bunch of Trump haters." Wow, that's pretty offensive, especially to the Republicans in the House. I mean, after 4 years of kissing ass and carrying water for this scumfuck, this is how they're treated? I mean, what's Trump so afraid of anyway? Nasty questions? Or just having an answer to the truth? Sounds like obstructionism to me, folks. And now for this week's daily death count. As of May 13th, we have nearly 85,000 deaths in just 3 months. USA! 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 Speaking of death, is Rush Limbaugh dead yet? I will do a jig of joy when that doctor shopping, pill popping, woman hating, race baiting, OxyContin junkie finally takes a dirt nap. Our world will be a better place when he's gone. And the same goes for every other Republican propagandist on television and radio. Sean Hannity, Laura Ingraham, Mark Levin, Mike Savage, Dennis Prager, Hugh Hewitt, they all deserve to die painfully for the lies and hate they spread to their gullible and ignorant followers. Can I get an amen? And speaking of separation of church and state, the Supreme Court is now debating the section of Obamacare that covers birth control. The defense claims companies should not have to provide birth control based on religious beliefs of the company or its owners. Folks, the only businesses that should be allowed to base its business decisions on religion or morality is a church. Furthermore, if your company is founded on religious principles, then you should apply to be a nonprofit group and give up your cash. You cannot serve both God and money. Matthew 6:24. That's the Bible, you know, that thing you profess to run your business by. And by the way, what happened to draining the swamp? I mean, we now know that at least four senators, three Republicans and one Democrat, sold off large amounts of their stock before the virus hit. Coincidentally, these senators were also briefed on the dangers of the virus before the general public. Dianne Feinstein of California, Richard Burr of North Carolina, James Inhofe of Oklahoma, and Kelly Loeffler of Georgia, whose husband just happens to be the chairman of the New York Stock Exchange. Wow, go figure. They made $1.2 million on their sales. And in her defense, Loeffler tweeted, "This is a ridiculous and baseless attack. I do not make investment decisions for my portfolio. They're made by multiple third-party advisors without my or my husband's knowledge or involvement." Bullshit. Lock them up. And in another clear case of Republican cronyism, Trump named Louis DeJoy as the new Postmaster General. Who is Louis DeJoy, you may ask? Well, he just happens to be a very close ally of the president and a huge fundraiser for the Republicans. No conflict of interest there, I'm sure. Essentially, Trump is trying to destroy the U.S. Postal Service from the inside, basically in order to raise rates on Amazon while also busting the Postal Union. What a dick. Speaking of dicks, Attorney General Barr had the DOJ close the Michael Flynn case, even though Michael Flynn lied to the FBI and Vice President Pence. I guess this is so Trump won't have to pardon him now. Finally, Trump asked the Supreme Court to block the release of documents from the Mueller investigation to the House of Representatives. What doesn't he want them to see? Wake up, America. Donald Trump is a fucking criminal. End of story. Period. But I digress. As I promised, a special feature coming up this week on What the Hell Was That that I'm calling Life in the Villages. So, take a little breather. We'll be right back with more fun. Roll it, Kev.
Well, howdy, folks, and welcome back to another fantastic episode of What the Hell Was That. I'm Todd Baker, just relaxing here in my miniature swimming pool, since the pools here in the Villages are currently closed. But during this pandemic, I'm just trying to enjoy myself as best as possible. I'm planning on taking the summer off and enjoying myself for the first time since I was about 15 years old. So, folks, I'm going to be showing you around the Villages, taking you around on my golf cart, showing you this lovely area and all that it has to offer. So, sit back, relax, you're watching What the Hell Was That?
You know, folks, if this is what retirement life is like, I'm down. I never want to work again if this is the case. I'm enjoying my pool. I think I'm going to pick up my golf clubs. I've got a set of golf clubs, and I think it's about time I start using them, folks. I am here in the Villages, Florida. We've got 47 golf courses available to us at all times. I think it's about time I actually start acting like a retired person. So I got my beer. I got my smoke. I'm reading my new book by Pamela DeBar. You know, life is good, folks. I hope you're doing well, and we'll be back with more. What the hell was that?
Well, it is a beautiful day here in sunny Florida in the Villages, and I figured I'd take you on a little tour and show you around town. Now, as any good villager knows, you've got to have a golf cart. I think they're pretty much required down here. Everyone's got their own personal insignias, whether what their team they support, what town they're from. We're Buckeyes, folks. We got a Buckeyes golf cart. This one's name is Woody. And the grandkids love to drive it. It's actually kind of fun. And no one seems to mind if you got a beer while you're driving down here. So I love it. We're going to take a little drive around and go hit some golf balls and see how many people are crammed into the pool today. And we'll be back with more fun on What the Hell Was That?
Well, here we are at our mailbox area. This is probably the biggest excitement that Mom and Dad have of the day, is going to collect the mail. Usually there's nothing in there but bills and crap whatsoever, but still, it's something to do to get out of the house. So this is just part of the daily routine here at the Villages. Well, you know, folks, I've never owned golf clubs in my life, but thanks to my buddy Mick, I've got a set now. So, you know, I've never played golf. Well, that's not true. I played golf in high school and gym class, but it's not quite the same. So we're going to have bust these bad boys out today and see what we can do. Hang tight. All right, so it's been since Mr. Howell's gym class in 1983 that I've actually tried to attempt to swing a golf club, so. See, I looked it up a little bit on the internet. I think you're supposed to grip something like this. You know, wiggle your ass a little bit, bend your knees, keep your eye on the ball. Hey, I hit it. Let's try another one. Mick, this is for you. Thanks for the golf club. Look at that. Straight on. Like ESPN. There's no other sports to watch on television right now. What the hell? Wiggle my ass. Oh, totally missed. One more. What you want to do is hit it right in the bullseye. Make a room. For you. How about that one? I might go pro. Just for good luck. Slicing a little bit. This is the keeper right here. Mm-hmm. Third time's the charm. Satisfied until I hit the bullseye. A little low. For Bill Murray. Oh, he got all of that! Cinderella story. 18th hole at Augusta. Close. Mick, I'm coming for you. Now that's what I'm talking about. We'll be back with more What the Hell Was That? And welcome back to another fantastic episode of What the Hell Was That here, folks. We are in the Brownwood Square here in the Villages, Florida. We have three of these large square communities down here where they've got bars, they got movie theaters, they got more bars, they got AT&T, they got Dunkin' Donuts, they got Guy's Fries, and we have dancing on the square, or at least used to, every night from 5 until 9 o'clock. Now, due to the virus, we're still slowly opening now. Our lovely governor has allowed restaurants to be open, which doesn't exactly sound like a real smart idea to me. You never know where those people in the kitchen have been. And if your server's wearing a mask, it doesn't exactly make me feel confident about having something to eat at dinner. But as you can see, there's plenty of yahoos out here just getting their drink on. And they could care less whether or not they're safe or not. So, yeah, hey, you know, like I say, folks, the more Trump supporters that die, the better off we'll be in November. So, you know, I think of it as a positive thing. So we're going to take a little walk around the square here, and we'll be back with more What the Hell Was That?
Yes.
And we're back. So, like I said, folks, this is our lovely square area where we normally would have bands on stage. And we've got a large concession area back here for people to stand and sit on the stands and come out and rock and dance with their grandkids. And, you know, that's pretty much how they spend their nights down here. So, you know, it's unfortunately not going to be doing that for a little while because I guess it's kind of hard to keep 50 people or less in a confined space. So until that happens, I guess we're not going to have that. But like I said, at least you can go to the restaurants if you feel like doing so. Movie theaters aren't open yet, which is fine by me because I can pretty much see everything on television anyhow. And, you know, for those who are, you know, missing out or, you know, want to reopen America, well, take a look, folks. This is what reopening in Florida looks like. So you got what you wanted. We'll see what happens in phase two. So we'll be back with more What the Hell Was That? Well, folks, as you can see, the restaurants down here are open, although you do have to sanitize your hands, I guess, before you even walk in the place. And apparently social distancing isn't really that important because they got 8 people at a table right there and none of them wearing masks. So I guess we're all just taking the advice of our wonderful president and vice president. We're not going to wear one. So, yeah, that's great. So, you know, me personally, I'm not going into these places for at least another 2-3 months because I guarantee half these people are going to be dead in about 3 months, so wait till it spreads out a little bit. So on that positive note, we're going to go check the death count. I think we're up to about 85,000 so far. So go America, USA. We'll be back with more. As I said, folks, the golf cart thing is not a myth. This is pretty much required down here in the villages, and you would not believe the money they'd spend on some of these things. Oh, look at that, Trump 2020. Where's that pinhead sitting at? Dumb motherfucker. So again, everyone just drives a little golf cart and pulls right up to the bar, and that's pretty much how things run down here. So we'll be back with more fun on What the Hell Was That? And we're back here. What the Hell Was That? Just taking a little drive home, actually using the car tonight, not the golf cart, but makes it a little easier and faster sometimes. So the sun is setting here in the villages. It's almost 7:30, so people are getting ready for bed. And, you know, so pretty much by 9 o'clock, this entire town is shut down. I could stand butt naked in the driveway at 9:15 and no one would ever know. So we'll test that theory a little later. I'll be back with more What the Hell Was That? Now here is something that you don't see every day in your neighborhood. Just a family of cranes walking through the yard. This is actually a common occurrence here in Florida. Not with the little babies though, they actually got the little babies. Yeah, so we get a little bit of nature here on our villages trip. Again, something you just don't see every day. Well, folks, the sun is setting, the lamppost is on, and that means it's almost nutty night time here in the villages. Like I said, most folks go to bed about 9:30 or so. So anyhow, I hope you enjoyed your little trip around the villages, and we'll be back to show you more fun later on What the Hell Was That? Next week's episode of What the Hell Was That will definitely not be brought to you by Trump Water. Get that shit out of here. Well, folks, that about wraps up this week's episode of What the Hell Was That? Join us next week when we'll be reading some viewer mail and perhaps even having some special guests. And as promised, cute cat videos. as promised, cute cat videos. Roll over. Good kitty.
Womp, bomb, loom, bomb, lomp, bomb, bomb, tooty poot, oh, rude. 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 Oh, womp, bomb, loom, bomb, lomp, bomb, bomb. I got a girl named Sue. She knows just what to do.
Hello, America. Are you afraid Donald Trump's going to steal another election? Does the idea of looking at his smug smile and oddly orange face for another 4 years just make your skin crawl? Yet you still can't bring yourself to vote for that sleepy, creepy, geriatric Joe Biden? Well, now you have a choice. Vote for me, Todd Baker, a true libertarian. I'm not a lawyer. I'm not a banker. I'm not a real estate mogul or executive CEO. And I'm definitely not a billionaire. The only silver spoon I ever got was a gift at mom's baby shower. I wasn't raised with a nanny, chauffeur, or a parade of servants. I was never given $1 million to start a new life. And I definitely never had a rich daddy get me out of serving in the military. No, I come from a modest, loving, hardworking American family. Matter of fact, the Baker motto is, we're not rich, we're happy. I was raised in the Lutheran faith and believe in the words of Jesus. I've never been married, so I've never committed adultery. I've never been divorced, so I've never broken the sacrament of marriage. I have no children, so I have no unqualified kids to put on my staff. I've never slept with a porn star or Playboy model. I have no secret offshore bank accounts. I've never been to Russia, let alone made business deals with them. No, I support the idea of peace over war. I support our troops, but I'd rather see them come home. I support national defense, but we spend far too much on the military. I support capitalism, but not at the cost of the consumer. I support the Constitution as a living document designed to be interpreted and reinterpreted by current and future generations. I support freedom of any kind, as long as you're not hurting anyone else. I support freedom of speech, as long as it isn't hate speech. I support your right to bear arms, if you're not violent or crazy. I support freedom of religion and separation of church and state. I support gay marriage, gays in the military, gay teachers, gay parents, gay presidents, and gay priests. Just leave the kids alone. And finally, I support a woman's right to choose. A fetus is not a human being. Abortion is not murder. A heartbeat does not a life make. Brain function and viability outside the womb make a human being. Pull a fetus out of 12 weeks and see what kind of quality life it has. And the only man who gets to have a say in a woman's right to choose is the guy who knocked her up. So unless you are willing to help feed, clothe, house, and educate these little bastards, you're just creating another generation of poverty, despair, and depression. Now, how do I propose to make things better? What possible solution does a layperson like myself have to offer? Well, it's one simple idea. However, I believe with just one idea, we can change the world. With this one idea, we can accomplish many different goals. Would you like to reduce our national debt, shrink our federal government, get rid of unnecessary government agencies, cut wasteful government spending, decrease our prison population, create new industries and millions of new jobs, see small businesses thrive again, bring back the clothing industry from overseas, find an alternative fuel source, and the opioid epidemic? Do you want to find a cure for cancer and other diseases? We can do all of that with this one simple idea. Legalize marijuana. Yeah, it's true, folks. And in fact, I could do that on my first day in office. All we need is a new head of the FDA and someone willing to change marijuana's status from Schedule 1 to Schedule 2. Simple. So if you support freedom, equality, human rights, and just doing the right thing, vote for me this November. Otherwise, expect more of the same. Or worse. I'm Todd Baker and I approve this message.
Rocky, stop eating grass.